ready?
Deuteronomy 28, 68. And the Lord shall bring thee into Egypt again with ships.
And the Lord did bring us again into Egypt. Egypt being basically another bondage, man. You know, that word Egypt means just bondage or house of bondage. You know, that's what it was known for back in those days, man. You know, go ahead, read.
By the way whereof I spake unto thee, thou shalt see it no more again.
What? But what's that? We wasn't going to see no more again? Was our own home, our own land, man. And this is the part right here what gets me with you, Jakes, man. And how you can't understand, you know what I'm saying? Because since we growing up, man, we've always said, man, we don't have our own land. You know what I'm saying? We've always knew that, man. You know what I'm saying? And this is right here in the scriptures, bringing forth, telling you what your land was, man. It was Israel, man. We didn't know what it was back then. We thought it was what?
Africa,
one of the countries. We didn't even know where we was from. We had no idea that we was from Israel. We thought we was from West Africa, South Africa, all of Africa. We was just fucking dumb, lost, and docile, man.
Right.
This is how bad it got for us, man.
Yeah.
Because why? Breaking the law, statutes, and commandments.
Yeah. Get that in Baruch. Yeah. You got some more of that?
Yeah, go ahead, read that.
And there ye shall be sold unto your enemies.
See, and who are our enemies? You know, the so-called white man, Esau. You know, so-called white man is the devil that the Bible speaks of, man. You know, we were sold into him. And he still is our enemy to this day, man. And you can't say this white man ain't your enemy, man. You know, look what he do. He pollute the food. He pollute the air you breathe, man. You know, he rob you of rest. He put drugs, guns, disease in your communities. That sounds like some shit an enemy would do, man. Just like what he did to our brothers, the Gadites and the Reubenites, man. The smallpox, man. It's the same thing when he put AIDS in your community. That's how you know it's talking about him, man. He uses the same dirty-ass tactics, man.
Drugs?
To keep Jake dumb and docile to finding out who they are, man. You know, keep them all lost and lost and messed up, man. Go ahead, read.
For bond men and bond women.
Right, that's what happened to us, man. We were sold to our enemies for bond men and bond women. That's why our women walk around so loose now, man. That's part of it, man. Part of them curses, man. Go ahead.
And no man shall buy you.
And ain't nobody gonna buy you. You know, going back into the Birth of a Nation movie, that word buy means save in the Hebrew, man. Nobody's gonna save you. That's why he wasn't successful with that revolt, man. That's why, you know, the Lord said, hey, nobody gonna save you. Who gonna save you? Yahweh Shai is, man. That's who gonna save us up out of this bondage we in, man. Yahweh Ba'ashim Yahweh Shai, the one when he gonna come in on the chariot, man. For those who believe on him, man, not the whole nation this time, man. The whole nation of Israel is not gonna be saved, man. Only one third, man, in the elect, man.
Because the whole nation of Israel don't wanna be saved. When you read Amos 9 and 10, it says, all the sinners of my people, all the sinners of my people shall die. Yeah.
Somebody get that.
Real quick.
Well, it also says what in the book of Isaiah says, what you have made a covenant with death.
Yep.
You know?
Yeah.
An agreement with hell. You know? Mm-hmm. You know, and you're in agreement with hell. Man.
Yeah.
You know, so you guys love death, man.
You got some more of that?
You know?
No, they'll say it on
the
Tuesday.
Yeah, go to get that in the roof, man. Yeah.
You got that 9 and 10 real quick?
Yeah, get that 9 and 10. Go ahead, read
it. Real fast.
Amos 9, 10. All the sinners of my people shall die by the sword.
So, like the brother said, man, all Israel ain't been saved this time. All the sinners of my people, which is the two-thirds who have not been redeemed out the earth, all the sinners of my people shall die by the sword. Keep reading.
Which say the evil shall not overtake nor prevent us.
Which say the evil shall not overtake or prevent us. So, first of all, They're not even worried about Jacob's trouble and that shit. Well, you even got Jakes that believe, they think they believe in the Bible, but they say, the Lord ain't coming back. We got another 20 years.
Yeah.
We got another 15
years.
Some
Jakes that believe to say, hey, I know I'm an Israelite. I know I'm going to die. At least I get the word right back in the kingdom, though. It's like getting ordered right back in the kingdom.
But still, huh?
Hey, you know them slayers in the streets that's going on, man. Jake community, man.
Right.
That's stabbed by the sword, man. Because that's what the scripture just said, man. It said that all the sinners shall die by the sword, man. And ultimate end of that is the nuclear missiles. But right now, it's the guns that these motherfucking Europeans gave you.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying? These Edomite crackers gave you to use against each other, man. You niggas dying by these swords, they all the fucking time, man. And these babies getting shot in the fucking head. And y'all be like, oh, the baby didn't do shit. Hey, but the baby was a sinner before, you know what I'm saying? Before it was born, man.
Yo. So I would die, ever prior to being innocent. Hey, and like the mother said earlier, man, you got people out here saying that we got another 25 years. But guess what? I had to custom eye on the script on something in that same fashion the other day. First of all, yeah, no man knows the hour or the time.
Yep.
Well, guess what? You only know what time you got to go to work is when you look at the clock. Okay, so guess what? the scriptures is a time clock, man.
Time.
How long America got.
That's right.
Like it said, when you see the abomination and the desolation, if we're not seeing abomination, you got Obama just passed the gay rights law. That's an abomination, okay? Desolation, don't you see the wars over there? We've been having wars and rumors of wars, so you can't go to that. You know what I'm saying? So when you see these things coming to pass, then know the time is nigh. So we know we are closer to the time now than we ever was.
Just like for instance, for instance, look at the weather, man.
Yeah.
You know what I'm saying?
Yeah.
You know, the weather don't even know what it want to do, man.
Yeah.
We don't even know the spring from fall, from winter to summer.
And even with that, that's scripture. Because it says what, man? We're not ignorant to Satan's devices. We know how the weather like that. But do niggas know? See, I knew back at the time, he wasn't going to be able to get, the earth is given over to the hand of the wicked. So Yahweh Shai is not, he's in control, but it's been given over to him. So guess who's in control of the who's in control of the weather? The prince of the power of the air.
That's why
he got hurt. That's why he's controlling his weather. Yahweh Shai was like, hey, look, the earth is his for a little while. He's controlling everything. So that's why we don't know the seasons and the times.
That's right.
Because his wicked ass device is
what? Well, he ain't gonna let him be too carried away saying, try to go out to the space station. All right, nigga, hey, hold on.
Get that. Hey, but that's scripture too.
No, trying to get too carried away. Because
scripture says what? When you come dwelling in the heavens, then when I come, Isaiah.
It's in Obadiah and it's
when they start
Amos.
Dealing with the stars, you know, the Lord, Yahweh Shai is going to come back, man. All right? And they've been dealing up there in them heavens for what? About what? Like 30, about 50 years?
Trying to.
You know what? What's that movie? That movie, The Girl Figure? A lot of people don't know that movie is not about when they so-called tried to put a man on the moon. That's not about that. That was when they orbited the earth, not put nobody on the moon.
Yeah, yeah.
So they did orbit. You know what I'm saying? Because that's how that guy had to go up there, because that's how they got their space stations up there. But it took Jake. Look who it took to get him up there, man.
Yeah,
Jake woman, man. You know? So we ain't down on all women, man. We know that it's women that's gonna be making out of this thing too, man.
Elect.
A very slim few though, man.
Yeah.
All right. But I didn't want to get off point.
I got a precept.
Now hold on.
That Baruch. Somebody
yes, right. Bring that Baruch out.
Bring that Baruch out.
It's another scripture. We didn't go on to captivity. We didn't go out into captivity upon the Esau at his own hand. It was the Lord that put
it. I get that.
All right, go ahead.
I got Baruch 4. I'm gonna start at 1. And I'm gonna go all the way down to the point.
It says, "This is the book of the commandments of the power, and the law that endureth forever." So the law is not done away with. "All they that keep it shall come to life." You shall be, your name gonna be written in that book, man. "But such as leave it shall die." And that's 2/3 ass Jakes, man.
Go down a little more.
Yeah, yeah. Okay, I'm gonna go straight to it then.
Just keep reading.
Yeah, I wanted to get.
Okay, go ahead. Come on, y'all got it.
He says, "Turn thee, O Jacob, and take hold of it,
walk in the presence of the light thereof, that thou mayest be illuminated. What's walking in the light, man? These the commandments, the laws, the statutes, the scriptures themselves, man. That's the light, man. That's our path in a world of darkness. You know what I mean? That's the path. And it said we shall be illuminated. Because, you know, you're going to be in that light for so long, the light going to shine on you. What happened to Moses? You know?
Which is prophecy to show that who's the real illuminator?
We the Illuminati. Hey, man, what happened with Moses, man, when he was up there in the mountains with the Most High? We had a shack, it's like, man, he came back down, his face was illuminated, man.
Had a glow on him.
He came back down, he was shining so hard, they couldn't even look upon his face, man. That's what's going into, man, because he had the knowledge and the wisdom and the understanding of all things.
Scripture
due to how we're not giving it to him.
Go ahead.
Scripture say wisdom makes the man face to shine. That's right. Why sometimes, you know what I'm saying, you might catch people looking at us. Sometimes I be looking at brothers. I'm like, damn, I've been looking at this brother for a long. You know what I'm saying?
But what did the Lord say? He said, let your light so shine. You know, so that's just the spirit, man. Let your light so shine that others that may see you, that they may want to serve your heavenly Father, which is in heaven. Basically, and that's what we're doing, man. We are the light, man, of Yahweh Bashim Yahweh Shah, man. Out here in the highways and the byways, shining bright for all these people to see, man.
That's why you got scriptures like what? It says they find it strange that we run not the way they run. They like this guy, something about this guy, man. Because around the whole entire world, McDonald's, currency exchange, tattoo place,
weed,
all that. That's all darkness, man. And, you know, and to have somebody come and say, hey, man, that's not right. This is right. What you're doing is wrong. Others like that, it's going to be fine. It's just like, man, this guy's different, man.
Back to Amos. They hate him that rebuketh in the gate, man.
Right. Yeah.
Our people don't want to, because we, John 3:19. And
get
this
it.
Is the con.
John 3:19. Get it.
Keep free.
No,
you got done with that?
No, I'm not finished.
Get down to the point. There's not so many
steps
down.
It says, this is Barak 4:6. It says, you were sold to the nations, not for your destruction, but because ye moved the power to wrath. Ye were delivered unto the enemy.
Yeah, so it says, you were not sold to the nations for your destruction, because if that was the case, we would have been destroyed. You see the shit they've been doing? They not only killing us, but they poison us. Like, look at in Chicago, that housing project where I grew up in, it's fucking totally empty because they done had lead and arsenic poisoning for over 100 years in that plot of land where Jake just been staying at. Jake going to the doctor for ADHD. Everybody got ADHD. ADHD, bipolar, ADHD, cancer. Lead poison, cancer.
You know, Jake probably died over there. I mean, these kids, man, they got all that stuff, man, because of that shit, man. Yeah. You know? Look at all the shit this devil did, man.
So if we were sold for our destruction, shit, we would have been destroyed, man.
Yeah. Actually, you know, the scriptures, you know, where it tells you that my people are destroyed, but it ain't speaking it. Mm-hmm. But it ain't, not even just that. My people are destroyed, man. Because we fucking wicked now. Our people. Not us, it's a lot, but I was speaking as in the whole. But I shouldn't even count myself, because they Jake with Israel. But get to the point, man. Our people, they destroyed, man. They destroyed due to the system, man. They destroyed due to not knowing. Like you said, lack of knowledge. Our people are destroyed, though. Still in awe, though. But like most I said, he didn't do it to destroy us as far as, like, eliminate us.
But Salakia, though, they are destroyed before lack of knowledge, though. You know what I'm saying? That's exactly, you know what I'm saying, why they lost. You know, because they don't have what we have, man.
Jake don't stand for shit now.
Man, we got the truth, man. Right. We got the 100% truth from the apostles, man. You know what I'm saying? GMS, great millstone, man.
Israel is spineless.
You know what I'm saying? And our people out here, they don't have nothing, man. You know what I'm saying? All they got is what? They got they got Jesus Christ.
Yeah.
They got Buddha, Allah,
and their grandma.
And their grandma, right?
Uh-huh.
Or their mama. Uh-huh. You know what I'm saying? All these false gods out here, or they whites.
BET,
you know? And they gonna stay like that, man. As long as they keep on walking past this light.
Yeah, Barack Obama, but he left.
Right, they have Barack Obama.
But actually he out here trying to promote his new center that he building up in Chicago. Him and his him and Michelle Obama. You know, they came back trying to promote that bullshit, man. But
getting to it, he ain't coming like annihilate us completely. Like how he had Joshua.
I would not utterly destroy it because you know, man, Yahweh gave
the order to Joshua to go and eliminate them people, man. They was eliminated, man, off the face of the earth. Their whole bloodline was cut right then and there. But that ain't what Yahweh wanted for us, man. He wanted this to be a lesson to us, man.
But their bloodline wasn't cut because the scripture says, no, there's no end to no nation.
There's no end to all the people.
It's no end to all the people. So that bloodline still here is just, they were created to be the weak. If they was making back here, guess what? They're going to come back. They're going to be through that same road.
And going back into it, when he said, he was sold to the nations, not for your destruction. Just like the scripture we read earlier, the scripture said, in the land of their captivity, they shall remember themselves. Mm-hmm. So this is our chastisement. This is how the Lord don't the scripture say if the Lord chastening whom He loveth. Mm-hmm. You know what I'm saying? Right. So the Lord showing us we just enduring our punishment.
Right.
But if the scripture says if you don't endure chastisement, which are all partakers,
right, yeah,
because we all you gonna go through your chest, you gonna get chastised whether you know it or not.
Right.
The scripture says judgment go forth every day, but man perceiveth it not. So whether you understand, see, that's what separates Israel from Jacob.
Yeah.
We understand what's going on.
Right.
We understand that we move the Most High to wrath. The scripture say you move me to wrath.
Huh.
So we transgressed against our power.
Right.
And so he punished us by letting those who are not a people rule over us.
Mm-hmm.
He let those who they not the Lord's people. They beneath us.
But see, he did that because why? Israel did what? They followed behind heathens.
That's right.
You know what I'm saying? To serve false gods, man.
Provoked them to wrath.
You know what I'm saying? And they provoked the Most High to jealousy.
Mm-hmm.
You know what I'm saying? And then here it is, Lord. You know, He showed us all of these wonderful works, man, when He brought us up out of Egypt. You know what I'm saying? He showed us the pillar, the cloud by what? The cloud by night and the pillar.
Cloud by day, pillar of fire by night.
Yeah, con. He showed us all of these things right in our face, man. And what did they do, man? They still continued on to sin, man. They rejected the Most High, man. Man, it's like these niggas didn't have no fear of the Lord, man. You know?
Hey, you know it's even more.
But I'm
super cold. Hey, man, he told Joshua told the Most High to stop the sun from going down, man.
He did it. He showed
He stopped the fucking sun from going down.
Yeah, come on. And he split the He did it twice,
man,
just to show that he was with Joshua the second time, man.
God.
You know?
Stop the fucking sun, man.
But let me, I'm gonna pull up that scripture real quick for you. This is Leviticus 26:44.
Yeah.
It says, and yet for all that, when they be in the land of their enemies, I will not cast them away, neither will I abhor them to destroy them utterly, and to break my covenant with them, for I am their power.
Yeah, and that word abhor mean hate. So the Lord don't hate us. He hate you other motherfuckers. You other heathen nations. For those who God don't hate nobody. For those who believe that.
There's more to it too.
Go ahead, brother.
It's like
abhor me, abomination.
Verse 45. It says, but I will, for their sakes, remember the covenant of their ancestors.
Mm-hmm.
See, he said, for their sakes, man, he gonna remember the covenant of our ancestors, man.
To back that up, get Deuteronomy 10 and 15.
Kai.
Mm-hmm.
You got it. Go ahead, brother.
Mm-hmm.
Real quick, because he said, I will remember for their sakes, I will remember the covenant of their ancestors. The Lord is not a power where he can lie.
Right.
So he chastening us, but he not destroying us.
Now, bad word.
You got Deuteronomy 10, 15.
Deuteronomy 10, 15. Only the Lord had a delight in thy fathers to love them.
So, separation.
he chose their seat after them.